Welcome back. After that big rig build for my birthday, today's video is going to be nice and laid back. We're not going to have to paint anything. We're not going to have to glue anything together. Model Rectifier Corporation sent over some of their DaVinci series kits, including the brand new GET clock, the gear system rotation, escapement mechanism, and turbillion movement. We're going to be a little mechanical kit. You can find these at your favorite hobby retailer. I will link in the description to Model Rectifier's website so you can find out exactly what to look for. There are a whole bunch in this series. I've built a couple on the show. I know I built the flying machine, which is absolutely beautiful. I've shown the other clock on this website, so you can see that they've got quite a bit of cool model kits out there. You can pick these up at places like Hobby Lobby or online retailers. They are everywhere. They are for a lot of age groups. It says 14 plus, but feel free to build it up with the kiddos, the granddaughters, the grandsons, the nieces and nephews, the brothers and sisters. Have fun with these. You don't need any special tools. You're just going to assemble a kit and have fun, and that's what the hobby is all about. So kick back. We're going to put the Get Series together clock first. Woo! And then we're going to work on one of the other kits. They sent over two other kits. They sent over the leverage crane. So that looks pretty cool. And they sent over the DaVinci helicopter design. All these kits operate, they move, they have parts that you can play with, so they should be fun for all age groups. The first part up, they molded it in a fiberglass, or it looks like a fiber reinforced plastic, which looks like real wood. We don't need to do any work to it. It's very attractive. These would look beautiful in the display room if you have such a thing. We've got the larger mechanism. You can see that's not a small kit. We can see the base, nice size where these kind of things are going to go on. You're going to have a beautifully large model kit. I especially like the clocks in this series because they work and they are so cool. They're not going to keep accurate, perfect time. That's not what they're designed to do. We got all these type of cogs and gear wheels. I love that the whole kit press fits together. Makes everything very easy. I'll do that on camera. Not all of it, but a lot of it. The gears are, see how nicely those are molded? You're not going to have to clean those out. You're not going to have to get the hobby knife and do anything. You'll need some sort of a nippers to remove parts from the parts tree. We've got two little parts trees. So you'll just need a nipper. You could even use, if you're a beginner watching this video, you can even use a fingernail snipper to clip these off. Just don't use mom or dad's favorite one. We can see we got that. Now these are going to hold little weights to balance it, so you might need some quarters, 25 cent pieces. We've got all different types of pins, and see how lovely they're labeled? Even if you cut them off the tree where they say 2 and 3, it still says pin A, pin B, pin C on there. So this is very easy to assemble, easy to understand. On this side of the table, we've got all kinds of, look at that, cool gears going on over here. Gear covers. Look at this little beauty of a piece. Back in the day when Da Vinci designed that, this would have all been hand carved, cast out of metal himself, or if someone decided to duplicate it. A lot of his drawings were just drawings and they never actually built anything. We'll just keep tossing parts out here. You got some real neat chrome steel axles. I left those in a bag so I wouldn't drop them and lose them. Those will press into place. We got these awesome transparent red springs and gear pieces, little wheels for the mechanism. We've got this cool little part here. There's so much neat stuff in these kits. Check out this pre-painted clock face with the gears on the inside. Two separate pieces in that artificial wood. Looks like MDF to me is what it looks like they made the plastic look like. And then pre-assembled in its own little bag is this spring. So make sure you keep an eye on where that is. Don't lose it. Don't fall out, but it's a nice little spring that will run the clock for you. And it's not one of those sharp metal springs, so you don't have to worry. The manuals are very easy to follow. Color callouts telling you where to put the parts and what part number. So even the beginner modeler can get this stuff together. I'm going to start working on mine, and we'll be back. Next up, let's do the helicopter. Yes, the Da Vinci series helicopter kit. We're going to be putting that together. It's got his, like, the screw design on the top as it's spun around. And of course, they don't really think it was ever built, but he did make those cool drawings of it and the design. We'll take a look at the parts of it, and then we'll put this one together as well. We've got parts molded in black in its own bag. This thing must have a metal spring in it because it does feel like it's got a little bit of a weight to it. And it's pre-pressed together with a wind on it. So don't disassemble that. Leave it as it is. That's in the box when you open it up in its own little bag. We've got some gear wheels here. I like these style. They got these like large rounded pegs on them. Those are cool. We got our little, looks like almost like a clock wind-up mechanism. We got our assembly pins. No glue, no paint needed in this one, of course. We got the nice little base on this one that gives the name the Da Vinci's helicopter. And then we've got the simulated wood. Looks like the fiber reinforced plastic, or that's what it looks like to me. Always looks nice on there. Look nice on the clock. Looks nice on the wheel. You can see this side's got a large grain in it. All assembled. That's pretty awesome sauce. And then we've got, and this is the last of the plastic in the kit. That's how fewer pieces are in this one compared to the clock, are the cool blades of the helicopter. Now you could go through and paint these as wood, whether that is fabric. You could really make this look cool on the bench. But I need a wind down set of builds for a video that's coming out this Wednesday. So I'm going to be doing these all just as they are, because you can have fun without having to be an expert and do everything like that on a model kit. You can just enjoy yourself, and that's what I'm going to do with these. We got the large pin going through the top to hold all those pieces together. I'm going to assemble this one on camera as well. See you in a minute. Thank you. Time keeps ticking away when you're having a good time, and I had a good time assembling the three kits from Model Rectifier Corporation through Academy Models, the new GET clock. Look how cool that works. I've only got a dollar and quarters on each side. You don't even need that many. It's enough to weigh it down, and it just starts running by itself. If it doesn't, just give the flywheel a tap, and it will run, and the second hand will count through here, or whatever the time duration hand is on the bottom there. And then to reset the clock, all you have to do is grab the arms and lift them back to the top, and it will continue running until the arms go up and all the way drop all the way to the bottom and the weight stops. So that is outstanding. That is really cool. I can't believe that it works so well. And it goes click, 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 click. So just pay attention to the manual. Very easy to assemble. Follow the guides in the manual about what metal rods to put where for the axles and stuff on everything. And you too will have a very fun model clock when you're all done. Look at that, just click, click, clicking away. And we can just lift up the arms. And it sounds so cool, doesn't it? So let's put that on the side. That'll keep going while we're talking here and run out. Then I built the helicopter. We'll get him out front and center. The helicopter is really cool. It's got the helicopter section itself, which can come off. You can see how the gear train works. You can see how the windup works. That locking lever that we installed will stop that counterweight from spinning all the gears when you wind it up. You just turn your lever. I've got it wound all the way up. You can see the arrows. There's no mistaking which way to turn it. Then you just place your helicopter parts on the top. Take that lock switch. And you can turn it off at any time you want. You can hear the gears going around. The kids are going to love putting that thing together and having a good old time. Then, that wasn't it. Off camera, because I wanted to make this a super fun build so I could just do things myself. Off camera, I built the crane too. Why not get all three on the video instead of just showing the boxes? So we got the crane all set up on this side of the crane. You can see it looks like beautiful woodwork and all that. We've got a lever that says up and down. If you want to lower the weight, you'll switch it to down. If you want to raise the weight, you'll switch it to up. We got those cool looking gear teeth in the center. We've got our weight. They give you a steel ball bearing. All the plastic looks like wood on the other kits. Don't you think it's cool that clock's still running in the background making that noise? Sounds like we're on 60 minutes. So anyways, I just love having fun. So we've got the weight there. So when we want to raise it, we will turn the lever to up. The kit just presses together. I had it done in like 20 minutes, not even. And then we will move the lever. And the ratcheting mechanism will raise it up every time we pump the lever. Then we just turn it to down. And in real life, it'd be heavy, so it would let gravity take its way. But we'll pull it down and let it sit on the base. And then we turn it back to up. And this just illustrates the principle of his crane and how the gears work on the inside of the wheels and how the pegs work. And then to raise it back up, you can hear the gears, the ratchets working, and back up goes the weight. So that's a cool little mechanism. These are great for kids. These are great for people that want to illustrate the mechanisms from DaVinci. We got the clock back out here. It's just about out of time. Raise it back up, and there it goes again. So ultimately cool. Thanks a gajillion to Model Rectifier Corporation for sending these over. Three awesome DaVinci kits. They are all out right now. I will link to Model Rectifier Corporation's website in the description, and you can find these, of course, at your local retailer or online hobby shop, whichever you prefer. Thanks for watching the workshop. This is Chris. Make sure to smile, have fun, enjoy your hobbies, build the kits you want to see, and build them how you want to see them. And those four tips will make sure that you're always enjoying your relaxing pastime. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review.